No sign of injury or rabies. Could be anthrax. Could be something else. The animal is sick. We can't risk an outbreak this close to the reindeer herders festival. Put it down. You need to get back on the bear hunt. So it's time you understand what you're up against. The locals think that a radioactive mutant lives on Pustaya Mountain, but I know what's really up there, and it's my fault. Head to the area marked on the hunter mate, and I'll explain. My previous expedition. You know, there were enthusiasts, not professionals. Passionate amateurs, like Gunther Baden. One day I sent some of them to observe a rare, exotic bear. An albino brown bear. As long as they didn't provoke the animal, what harm could come from documenting its presence? But when the party came back to camp for dinner, they accidentally led the albino right to us. The animal was beyond hungry. It was starving. I put myself between the bear and the team and I shouted and I stood my ground, but it kept moving forward. It took one swipe and I was on the ground. I put both buckshot rounds from my shotgun into its chest. Point blank. It howled and ran off. I tried to get up and chase after it, but... Might as well rip this bandage off quickly. So, I can't walk. For now. With a year in physical therapy, maybe I will graduate from chair to crutches. I won't be dancing to Kalinka anytime soon, but at least, with your help, I'll see this expedition completed. Clean up the mess that I made. Anyway, that's why I'm not out there with you. I wish I could be, but... Sorry, this is not a pity party. I think the albino is still alive. I should have had slugs loaded in my shotgun, but I never thought this one would sneak up on us. I would be overjoyed to find out I'm just being paranoid. But to prove it beyond a doubt, you're heading for the albino's den. Be careful, and we'll see what we find. Maybe in this case, my paranoia is justified.